If you want to pass the GED Social Studies exam, you need to know what to study. When you have an understanding of what will be on the test, you can study more effectively. In this video, I'll lay out what you need to know about United States history to score 145 and pass the GED Social Studies exam. This is the third video in a series about the Social Studies exam. In the first video, we reviewed what are called the Social Studies practices, or the skills that you need to do well on the test. In the second video, we covered all the big ideas and vocabulary surrounding the biggest topic on the test, US civics and government. In this video, we'll be discussing the second most frequently appearing topic, US history. Having a better idea of what will be on the test can help you focus your attention on the best resources. This video will be far from exhaustive, but I hope it will be a good jumping off point for you as you begin your studies. Even though we'll be discussing US history in this video, I want to re-emphasize what I explained in the first video of the series. This test is not about memorization. They are not going to ask you about any names or any dates, and you don't have to worry about memorizing all the events or the wars or anything like that. However, it is really helpful if you have a general idea of the big themes and vocabulary that will appear on the test. That way, when you read the primary and secondary source passages, you'll have some context to help you answer the questions. I also mentioned before that the GED.com website doesn't really give a lot of suggestions about what will be on the test. They really only recommend that you brush up on those social studies practices skills. However, if you are completely unfamiliar with US history, you are going to be very confused. What I'll be sharing with you today is what appears in the Kaplan GED Prep Manual, and I do recommend that you either purchase a copy of that or borrow it from your local library. And I'll include a link down in the description if you want to check it out. As a GED instructor, I've had the opportunity to work from almost all of the GED Prep Manuals, and I am confident in the accuracy of what I'm going to present. According to the Kaplan GED Prep Manual, about 20% of the questions on the GED Social Studies exam are about US history. That means that along with the 50% of questions that are about US government and civics, about 70% of the test is about United States history and government. I'm not saying don't study the other two topics, but honestly, these are the most important parts. I find that it's really helpful if you're able to ground yourself on a timeline of what happens in United States history. That way, when you see what the decade or the century is that a reading is from, you have an idea of what was going on at that time. So let's go over the five big time periods in United States history that you should be familiar with. The first period stretches from the late 1400s all the way through the end of the 1700s. During this period, Europeans accidentally landed in North America, and then spent the next 300 years establishing colonies in order to extract the continent's rich natural resources. European colonization had and continues to have extreme negative consequences for the indigenous peoples of North America, many of whom died of exposure to new diseases, or else were killed, enslaved, or otherwise driven away from their ancestral homelands. During this time period, France, England, Spain, and the Netherlands fought over control of the continent, including during the French and Indian War in the 1700s. This conflict concluded with England taking control of all the land east of the Mississippi River. Following that conflict, England sought to reassert control over its colonies and to recuperate some of the expense of fighting that war. England implemented taxes that the colonists objected to. This led to an uprising by the colonists, the publication of the Declaration of Independence on July 4, 1776, and ultimately the Revolutionary War. The Revolutionary War ended in 1783 with a recognition of American independence. The newly independent nation established a weak central government that really emphasized the power of the states in the Articles of Confederation. However, not long after, a stronger central government was established by the US Constitution, which was ratified in 1788. The second period of time covers the next 100 years or so. The major conflict of this time had to do with the legality of slavery in the new nation. Throughout the colonial period, large numbers of enslaved Africans had been forcibly brought to North America, and their unpaid labor was used throughout the colonies. However, by the early 1800s, the economy of the northern states was diversifying to include industry and commerce as well as agriculture, and slavery was abolished in the northern states. During this period, the United States began to expand westward and add more states onto the Union. This led to fierce debate over whether slavery should be allowed in the new states. Both states that allowed slavery and states that did not were vying to be in the majority. In 1860, with the election of President Abraham Lincoln, who had vowed to prevent the spread of slavery into the new territories, the southern slaveholding states seceded from the United States and created their own government called the Confederacy. This led to a bloody and costly civil war fought mostly in the South. Ultimately, the Civil War ended with the Confederate General Robert E. Lee's surrender to Union General Ulysses S. Grant. During the 12 years that followed, federal troops oversaw the reconstruction of the damage that had been done in the South. The enslaved people who had lived there were legally free with the passage and ratification of the 13th Amendment. However, despite the abolishment of slavery, new forms of structural racism and voter suppression prevented these newly freed people from fully exercising their rights as United States citizens. In the third period of our timeline, the late 1800s and early 1900s experienced rapid industrialization. Factories sprung up surrounding the country's big cities, including Boston, New York, Philadelphia, Pittsburgh, and Chicago. Cities had large populations both to work in the factories and to buy the products that they were producing. During the late 1800s, immigrants from other countries were drawn to cities with the promise of work in these factories. In response to the harsh and dangerous working conditions in those factories, as well as the low pay for long hours, workers began to unionize to fight for higher wages and safer conditions. Many worker protections that still exist today were hard won by these unions, including the 5-day work week. The early 1900s is known as the Progressive Era, and many social and political reforms, including the right of women to vote, were passed during this time period. A quick pause here. If this review is helping you to study for the GED exam, please take a second and press the like button. That really does help the channel by letting YouTube know that this is a good resource. And don't forget to subscribe so that you don't miss the rest of the videos in the GED Social Studies series. Thanks, and now back to the timeline. During the fourth period, industry continues to grow and expand. In search of both natural resources to use in production and a greater market of consumers to sell products to, the United States began a period of imperialism, becoming more involved with other countries both politically, economically, and militarily. During this time, the United States participated in a number of international conflicts, including the Spanish-American War, during which the U.S. gained control of the Spanish colony of Cuba, Puerto Rico, the Philippines, and Guam. The United States also became involved in World War I when Germany sank American ships. And following World War I, the Great Depression led to serious economic problems both in the United States and abroad, leading to the rise of fascism in many European countries. Ultimately, that resulted in another international conflict, World War II. Many atrocities occurred during this time, including the Holocaust. New military technologies led to horrific casualties, and the United States dropped 2 atomic bombs on Japanese cities. When the war was over, the Allied forces, including the United States, assisted many of the war-damaged countries to rebuild. The fifth and final period that appears on the GED test brings us from the 1950s all the way through to 1990. The 2 big overarching events that occurred during this period are the Cold War and the Civil Rights Movement. The Cold War was a power struggle between capitalist countries led by the United States and communist countries led by the Soviet Union. There was never open fighting between the two powers, but there was a constant threat of nuclear attack. Other conflicts, including the Vietnam War and the Korean War, were also related to this conflict between communism and capitalism. The Cold War finally came to an end in 1991 with the collapse of the Soviet Union and the end to communism there. Meanwhile, back at home in the United States, beginning in the 1950s, African American leaders initiated the Civil Rights Movement to demand the end of segregation and discrimination based on race. Their efforts led to legal protections from race discrimination, as well as integration of public schools and other public services and voter protections. However, these freedoms and protections have never been perfectly enforced, and civil rights leaders today still work to prevent voter suppression and discrimination. Okay, so those are the 5 big time periods in United States history that you want to be familiar with so that you can pass the GED Social Studies exam. Obviously, this quick overview left out a lot of detail and nuance that is important to have to truly understand the history of the United States. I strongly encourage you to take some time to learn more about US history, especially if you feel like you didn't really get a full understanding of it when you were in high school. I really recommend the US History series by Crash Course, and I will link that below. Other students that I've worked with have had great experiences using the US History series on Khan Academy. Again, please don't worry about memorizing any names or dates, but it's important that when you see a date on a passage, you can situate yourself on that timeline of US history. I also always recommend that you try out practice problems that are like what you're going to see on the test, and the Kaplan GED Prep Manual is a great resource for that. On this channel, I make videos about how to study more effectively so that you can achieve your goals. In the coming weeks, I'll be discussing the remaining content that appears on the GED Social Studies test, including economics and world geography, so please subscribe if you'd like to learn more. If you're just starting to think about studying for the GED exams, you can check out this video about how to get started with that process. Or if you're a little deeper in, check out my playlist about what you'll need to know to pass each individual subject test. If this video was helpful to you, please press the like button so that YouTube knows to share it with other studiers. Thank you as always for watching, and until next time, happy studying.